get your falling star and put it in your pocket, never let it fade away. Get your falling star and put it in your pocket, save it for a rainy day.
I started writing, and one night I had a big argument with my wife. I went to a place called the Copacabana in New York in the lounge. So I was in the lounge one night, there's a guy called Wally Schuster. I says, would you listen to one of my songs one day? He says, okay. So I wrote a song, a new song, and I thought he'd like. And about a week later, maybe it could have been no more than 2 weeks, I was at the Copa and here he walks in with two of his friends in the music business. I want to let you hear that song, a new song that I wrote. And he said, I'd sing. I said, all right. So I sang the song and he said, wait a minute. Did you really write this? I says, yeah. He says, look, here's my address. Come and see me at my office one day this week. I said, all right. Of course, sure enough, I called him, told him I was coming over. And we went in for a half hour and I sang the song. And when we finished the demo, one of the Fisher boys says, you know, Perry Como's coming up for a date. He says, and they're looking desperately for two more songs. I says, oh, well. And he played it for Como. Como said he was going to record it. Hey, this is my first song. I got Perry Como, the number one singer in the world. I mean, his own television show. That's when everything happened. I guess about a month after the song was cut, I get a call from the publisher that he's going to introduce a new song on his TV program, the Perry Como Show. But they don't know what it is. It's a big secret. So, sure enough, program was on. We're all waiting for the time he's going to announce what song he's in. And then they didn't announce it. And now Perry Como is going to sing his new release. He had a stick in his hand, a drummer stick, and he hit a bottle. Tick, 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 tick.
Get your falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Get your falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day. For love may come, tap you on the shoulder. Some starless night. Just in case. Isn't this a guesser?
It's our song. Sure enough, he sings Catch a Falling Star. Forget about it. The floor was wet. I peed my pants. And about a couple of weeks went by, about 4 or 5 weeks. We're going to a wedding for a mafia friend of mine. And I'm in my car and we're going. And that time we had a two-way radio that my father-in-law got because he knew somebody in the police department. And if there was an accident, we would hear it first and we'd get there. And I hear a police call say, accident on the Bell Parkway. I says, holy shit, to my wife. She says, you ain't doing anything. Yes, I am. So I went to the yard, I went into the office, put this rain suit on, got in the tow truck. I got there first, and two other tow trucks came. Now, while I'm hoisting the car up, I have Martin Block on, Make Believe Ballroom.
Hello, everybody. This is Martin Block.
It's Make Believe Ballroom time, and free to everyone.
And he's going to announce the number one song of that week. And all of a sudden, Martin Block says, ladies and gentlemen, the new number one song in the country today is Perry Como and Catch a Falling Star. Whoa! I'm stuck there. I'm saying, I can't breathe. So the cop says, what's wrong with you? I says, my song just went to number one. He says, what song? I says, I wrote Catch a Falling Star. He looked at me and says, you get that car out of here right now, or I'm giving it to the other two guys. Now get out of here. I said, here I got the number one song. And the first guy I told it's my song, he didn't believe me. So I got in the car, I looked out the window, and he still got his hands on his hips. I gave him an Italian salute, and he put his finger up. And I drove back to the junkyard where my wife is screaming, because she heard it on the radio too. I walked in and I was depressed. And she says, what's wrong? You should be jumping around with joy. And the first thing she says was, thank you, Jesus, for helping that me be number one. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be number one. And I looked at her and I said, you gotta be kidding with this Jesus. I says, I wrote the f-ing song. We had nothing to do with this f-ing song. She says, don't curse around Jesus. Oh my God. Well, anyway, that was my last day in the auto working business. And I went to New York and I opened up a publishing company. The rest is history. Star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away.
Catch your falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.
Save it for a rainy day.